Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa maulana Muhammadin sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And a special welcome and greetings to Cape Town TV for coming here today, Brother Imran Mukaddam, thank you. Eid al-Adha started this Sunday or Monday, but for many Yemenis, the celebration falls short because it's a time where a humanitarian crisis is taking place in Yemen. Yes, there are other hotspots that's taking place for years in Sham, in Palestine. But it seems that we have become desensitized by the constant, if I can call it, media, that our hearts have become so hard. We have to evaluate ourselves and see what is wrong with us. We are hearing through the news media, regarding Yemen in particular, the cost of the infrastructure and the damage and the economic losses since the breakout of the war in Yemen a few years ago has already reached 14 billion. And this is according to a recent joint report published by the World Bank, United Nations, the Islamic Development Bank, and the European Union. Now you can imagine the contractors and the subcontractors already wrapping their hands together, because when it comes to reparations, you know, war brings in money and it brings about a change in economic development for those countries like America that need war to sustain them. And we'll find these Zionistic companies are profiteering at the expense of the Arab nations, which is very sad. And we're allowing it to happen. We find the bombings are constant. The bloodshed continues. And the price of basics is so exorbitant, ya Allah. We are finding many countries are involved in this war. In 2015, Saudi Arabia formed a coalition of Arab states to defeat the Houthis in Yemen. And they consisted of Kuwait, United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, Egypt, Morocco, Jordan, Sudan, and Senegal. You know, in 8 hours, 8 countries were galvanized for war. But in 80 years, we couldn't galvanize anybody for our Palestinian brothers and sisters. Ya Allah. Right? What hypocrisy is this? What conscience is this have we got? Yes, we can claim that we're in the furthermost part of this world. But let me tell you, many years ago when I was in Palestine, they said, at least South Africa, especially Cape Townians, they are the most vociferous people to speak out for the Palestinian people. Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. In Yemen's war-ravaged city of Saada, thousands of people gathered on Monday for the funeral of 51 people, and 40 of them were children. And they were killed by the Saudi UAE military alliance backed by the United States. Then there was an airstrike which hit the wedding reception in a remote mountain village of Raqqa, where a celebration turns into devastation, and killing 22 civilians, including children, and of course including the bride, and injuring dozens. More than 3 years into this civil war, we find 16,000 civilians have been killed and injured, and the vast majority is by airstrikes. And the United Nations Human Rights Office estimates, adding that the figures are likely to be far higher. You know, there was a claim by the Saudi Arabians that they intercepted a ballistic missile from the Houthis that was coming into the Haram, Baytullah. Of course, the Houthis denied it. But the point here is who is telling the truth and who is not telling the truth is not the issue at this stage. The point here is how many civilians and innocent people and babies must be killed to sustain certain regimes, Ya Allah. Despite repeated petitions from the human rights groups to Western powers over the sales of arms to Saudi Arabia, whether it's the US, whether it's the UK, Canada, France, and Spain, they have all sold weapons. Because why? They are benefiting. Right? And it has been said between 2015 and 2010, the United States have a recorded sale of $90 billion of military that's been sent to Saudi Arabia. Who are they fighting? Why they need so much? Allah, Allah. The sad thing is we are in the month of Hajj and we supposed to take the lessons of this. The self-arrogation of the Khadimul Haramain, the protectors and making khidmat of the two harams. I really wonder if they are the protectors of the Black House. It seems to me they're more the protectors of the White House. This is a reality that we're tending to find ourselves in. Very unfortunate, Ya Allah. Our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making tawaf around the Baytullah and so beautifully explained in the hadith. He says, Ma atyabak wa atyaba rihak ma a'zamak wa a'zama hurumatak. He says, how delightful you are. As Nabi is walking, making his tawaf. He says, how delightful you are and how great is your scent. How magnificent you are and how great is your sanctity. وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدٍ. I swear by the one in whose hand is Muhammad's soul, the sanctity of a believer, his wealth and his blood is greater in the sight of Allah than your sanctity. And we do not think of him except good. So the heart of a believer is more valuable than the Baytullah. What is our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us and drawing our attention. Yet, unfortunately, we find indiscriminate killings. Yes, now we could go into a debate. Oh, they must be Shia, or they must be Sufis, or they must be Goofies, and you know, sidetracking again. The important thing to remember, children are being killed. Innocent people. The infrastructure in warfare in Islam, you leave places of worship alone. You leave agriculture alone. You leave old people and children alone. If you want to stick according to Islam, this is what it is, but it's not happening. Ya Allah, we ask Allah to make ease for our Yemenis, to make ease for Palestine, to make ease for Sham, and in China, and in Africa, and wherever they might be, Ya Allah, give them ease, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Because when we are busy sacrificing, what are we sacrificing? If you're only sacrificing to sacrifice, then that's butchery. There's another dimension to sacrifice. So when we do our sacrifice, our sheep, that when we truly say, Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. We say, tell to them, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Qul, verily, my prayer, my sacrifice, my living and my dying is for Allah. Isn't it so? The Lord of all the worlds. So don't think that we won't be tested, that it won't be easy, that we won't have sufferings. For Allah says in the Quran, we'll go through that process. Our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went through that process. Where Allah says, A'udhu billahi min shaytan al-rajim, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Am hasibtum an tadkhulul jannata walamma ya'tikum mathalul ladhina khalaw min qablikum. Do you think that you could go to paradise without experiencing the kind of suffering others have experienced before you? مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه distress and afflictions battered them until the messenger and the believers said, Mata Nasrullah, when will Allah send his help? Allah inna Nasrullahi Kareem. Certainly Allah's help is close by and near, subhanAllah. Ya Allah, Allah is drawing our attention to these great days of Hajj. Wal-fajr wa-layalin ashar, by the dawn and by the 10 nights. And in this beautiful hadith, our Prophet says, Ma al-amalu fi ayyami afdalu minha fi hadhihi. There are no days of good deeds more beloved to Allah than these days. In other words, these 10 days of Hajj. Qalu, and they said, the Sahabi said, Walal jihad, not even jihad. And the Prophet said, not even jihad. Illa rajulun kharaja yukhatiru bi nafsihi wa malihi fa lam yarji' bi shay'in. Not even jihad, except that a man who went to jihad with all his wealth and doesn't return back with anything. Subhanallah, drawing our attention. So when we speak about udhiyah, sacrifice, it is one of the great rituals in Islam which holds great meaning to us. And we signify the oneness of Allah and his blessings and his bounties. As Allah says, وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْ سَكَنْ لِيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. And for every nation, we have appointed religious ceremonies that they may mention the name of Allah over the cattle that he has given them for food. فَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُوا. And your Allah is one Allah. So you must submit to him. Ya Allah, subhanallah. Are we really submitting is a question that we have to ask. Are we truly Muslim? The Udhiyah is one of the religious symbols. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَدِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Allah says, such is his state that whoever holds in honor the symbols of Allah in the sacrificial of the animal, of sacrificing the animals, such honor should come truly from the piety of the heart. وَالْبُدْنَ جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٍ. And the budn, in other words, the cows and the camels and the sheep that are being offered for sacrifices, we have made for you as among the symbols of Allah, and therein you have much good. فَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا صَوَافَّ. So mention the name of Allah. And over them, when they are drawn up in lines, فَإِذَا وَجَبَتْ جُنُوبُهَا فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْقَانِعُ وَالْمُعَتَّرُ. And then when they are down on their sides after slaughtering them, eat from them and feed the beggar who does not ask and also the beggar who asks. In our community there are poor people. As we said, they are too shy to ask. Go look for them. Go look them up, go give them. Subhanallah, we have them. كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرْنَا لَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Thus we have made them subject to you that you may be grateful. Our Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam says through Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, she says that the Prophet said alayhi salam, no act performed on the day of Nahar by the son of Adam is more beloved to Allah than shedding the blood. In other words, sacrificing. Verily, it comes on the day of Qiyamah with its horns, its hairs, and nails. Allah gives the reward for it before its blood reaches even the ground. So be content for sacrificing. The Udhiyah, subhanAllah. Is from the fiqh point of view, is it farz, sunnah? No, please. It is wajib according to the Hanafi. It is sunnah mu'akkad. If you are by the means, do it, it's good. We can waste our money on everything else. Big variety shows and Bollywood and Hollywood shows. We want to spend money, but you can't make a sacrifice. Even if you can't do it, one for each person, our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is allowed. One for the whole family, mention all their names, no problem. Do it. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made his sacrifice. He said, taqabbal minni and from my ummati who were unable to do it. Look at his sacrifice. Subhanallah. So do it. Ya Allah. And try to witness your sacrifice if you are able to. Because Nabi alayhi salam says so beautifully to his daughter, Sitina Fatima. He says, come Fatima and witness your sacrifice, because your sins will be wiped off at his first drop of blood. And then say, Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. Subhanallah. La sharika lahu wa bidhalika umirtu wa ana awwalul muslimin. Subhanallah. So the one of the companions said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is this special for you and for your family or for all Muslims? For all Muslims. Subhanallah. فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْقَانِعُ وَالْمُعَتَّارُ, as we have said, eat therefrom. Eh? Feed the beggar who does not ask, and feed the beggar who asks. Implement feeding scheme programs. This country and whatever country in the world, the government are unable to assist when it comes to alleviation of poverty. Subhanallah, at least this time of the year. You can put smiles on the people's faces. Wallahi. The people are waiting for the slaughtered sheep. So we, various people and organizations and individuals can do the amazing and fantastic work. And whoever has niyyah to perform, don't remove your nails or hair. The person whom it is done upon, like your brother, sister, children, wife, they don't have to remove their hair. Only the person who is the main person, that person must not remove the hair, nails, etc. The wisdom of it is, we are tying ourselves with our fellow hujjahs that they are in the haram. This is the principle why it is not being done. So when we actually do the actual act, subhanallah, we are thinking of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the test that he went through. And I always love saying this. As you know, every time he cut it, he was frustrated. And he was frustrated to such a degree, he threw it, the knife away, because he couldn't carry out Allah's order. But when it hit the boulder split asunder. Eh? And then out of frustration, what did Nabi Ibrahim says? Why didn't you cut? And the knife answers, Bismillah. For the same reason you did not burn when Namrud threw you into the fire. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Eh? So all this comes back. So there's purpose for us when we do things. It's not cutting. No. No. No, please be careful, Ya Allah. Because Allah says in the Quran, لَيَّنَالَ اللَّهُ لُحُمُهَا وَلَا دِمَعُهَا. It is not the meat or the blood that reaches Allah. وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. But it is the piety from you that reaches Allah. May Allah grant us that piety, Ya Allah. Ya Allah. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَذِّمْ شِعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Such is his state that whoever holds in honor the symbols of Allah in sacrificing the animals, such honor should come truly from the piety of the heart. Ya Allah. Nabi alayhi salam is also teaching us. We speak about human rights. We speak also about animal rights. We know about it. Nabi alayhi salam has said, Inna Allaha katab al-ihsan ala kulli shay. That Allah has prescribed in anything that you do, that you must do it in a state of excellence. We don't believe, like we say in Afrikaans, kan Allah jobis. No, no. When it comes to masjid, no, inshallah, kan Allah jobis. No, subhanallah. If you look at this beautiful masjid, subhanallah, Allah bless the donor and the person who did this and the all and everybody. It was done in a state of ihsan. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when you cut, you also cut in a state of ihsan. فَإِذَا قَتَلْتُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا الْقِتْلَ. So when you kill, kill in a good way. Not talking about the enemies now, we're talking about sacrifice. Otherwise, hey, let me Imam Fakir for start now. You know, people are very quick to take us out of context. وَإِذَا ذَبَحْتُمْ فَأَحْسِنُوا الذَّبَحْ. And when you slaughter, slaughter in a good way. And when you fight in the way of Allah, in other words, you don't torture a person. When you defend yourself and you have to kill, you kill. Because you have the right to defend yourself. Subhanallah. So Nabi alayhi salam ends by saying, so every one of you should sharpen his knife and let the slaughtered animal die comfortably. Ya Allah. You know, if you reflect how much sheep are being slaughtered and killed worldwide, not only in the months of Hajj or on the days of Hajj, throughout the year. And if you look at it, a sheep only gives birth to one. Isn't it so? Doesn't give birth to a litter like dogs. Dogs give birth, ya Allah, to a litter of puppies. Isn't it so? Lots of them. But the dogs, oh, they carry on. But do you see the dogs roaming around like the amount of sheep is roaming around? Have you ever thought about it? The amount of slaughtering for eating purposes, yet the barakah and the blessings and the amount of sheep that is to be found. Allahu Akbar, that is barakah. That is really barakah. Can a mind fathom that? And this is when we sit at the feet of our shuyukh to explain. And this is one I reveal or share with you. Our shuyukh used to say, one day, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam asked Allah, oh Allah, show me your beloved servants. So Jibreel alayhi salam was sent to Nabi Ibrahim and Nabi Ismail alayhi salam tending the flock of sheep. As you know, all the prophets were tending. They were shepherds. Is that so? So Allah sends him down, and Jibreel comes in the form of a person. And Jibreel appears before the man. He says, oh stranger, who are you? What is your name? He said, my name is Ibrahim. I said, who is this? This is my son. He said, what are you doing here? He says, no, I'm just tending to my sheep here. Of course, Ibrahim alayhi salam is now worried. Why the first degree questions now, you know? Well, but having said that, these questions went on, and Jibreel went on questioning to such a degree by saying, oh Ibrahim, these flocks are so many for you. And Ibrahim alayhi salam says, no, it's not too many. He said, but if you like, I can share some of it with you. And Jibreel alayhi salam, in the form of a man, he says, I cannot afford. He says, no. The price that I'm asking is not much that I'm asking you. He says, the price of half the flock is under your tongue and between your lips. Subhanallah. He says, what is that? He says, it will take a few seconds to say. He says, say, Subuhun Qudusun Rabbul Malaikati Warruh. Most glorious and holiest Lord of the angels and the spirit. And Ibrahim alayhi salam says to his son, go take the half and put it on the side of our guest. Hey? And Jibreel, further testing alayhi salam, he said, what you got there is still too much. He said, okay, take another half of this, but say it again. And he repeats, Subuhun Qudusun Rabbuna Rabbul Malaikatu Warruh. And another one, another half goes. Nabi Ibrahim says to Jibreel alayhi salam, I feel that you want to ask for more. I will not wait for you to ask again. I shall ask you myself if you want more. And at that time, the malaikat were weeping at the generosity of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Subhanallah. And Allah said to his malaikat, I am creating from every drop of your tears an angel that will inhabit the earth until the end of this world. They will be my messengers in charge of protecting and guiding human beings until day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Subhanallah. That's why we understand the ayat of Quran. لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. For each person, there are angels in succession, before and behind him. They guard him by the command of Allah. We have our security service, which we don't even realize we have with us, subhanallah. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam says to Jibreel alayhi salam, now you say the words, Subuhun Qudusun Rabbuna wa Rabbul Malaikati Warruh. See the difference. The Rabbuna wasn't there before. It says, most glorious and holiest, our Lord, Rabbuna, Rabbul Malaikati wa Ruh, and the Lord of the angels and the spirit. And he tells his son Ismail Islam, give everything to him. Take everything, let everything go. And Jibril says, Ibrahim, wait. Wait. I don't need all these flocks. So Ibrahim alayhi salam says, oh Jibril, did you think I didn't know who you were? Eh? The moment you said, Rabbuna, my Lord and your Lord, subhanallah, you gave yourself away. In effect, says Ibrahim alayhi salam, I veiled myself from you. You did not veil yourself from me. Subhanallah. Ya Allah. Jibril was now baffled. What must he do with all the sheep? He wants to give it back. Allah tells him, a person who is generous will never take it back. And he won't speak about his goodness, of what goodness he does. Subhanallah. Eh? I have adorned Ibrahim, says Allah, with the attribute of mine, Al-Karim, the one who is generous. So direct these flocks of sheep, cows, goats, and horses, and donkeys, and buffaloes, and camels to the jungles of the earth, and appoint over them guardians of angels to look after them. My will is that these species of animals will never be extinguished from the earth because of Ibrahim alayhi salam's generosity. Subhanallah. Hence we find ourselves in the situation that we are in. May Allah grant us the wisdom of sacrifice, the wisdom to care for our fellow human beings, wherever they might be. And don't forget, the highest ibadah that we can do, we have not got the time to speak about it, is to make takbir, to make tahleel, and to make tahmeed. To say Allahu Akbar, to say La ilaha illallah, to say Alhamdulillah. This is in the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what we do. And oh people, dhikr is our lifeblood. There are people that are averse to it. But be careful. Allah mentions this in the Quran, and I end off with this. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ. And the one who is blinded, who is averse, who don't like to make the dhikr and the remembrance of the merciful one, نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا. We appoint for him a shaitan. فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ. Who will be a constant companion for all the time. Allah protect us from that, ya Allah. Allah doesn't put us into that state, of Allah. The dhikr we heard in the khutbah, in the salat tanha anil fakhshai wal munkar, isn't it? Allah, salah keeps us away from lewdness and all types of evils and so forth, and badness. وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. And the remembrance of Allah is the greatest. Because that's continuous all our life. May Allah grant us all the goodness. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Few announcements to be done. We make again dua for Janab Hazrat Latif Rawat, who passed away last Friday. He was hugely involved with the Mazar Society. Fellow Urdu student of mine, we went to Urdu school together in the 60s and the late 50s. May Allah grant him Jannah, ya Allah. Again, a good thank you. Jazakumullah, Brother Imran Muqaddam from Cape Town TV. Allah bless you for all the good work that you are doing. And welcome, Brother Fadil Hassan, first time, and many of the visitors that are here. Allah bless all of you. Labarang will be on Eid Day, inshallah. Look, people are asking me questions. When must we? And I'm giving you straight answers. When must we fast? You fast on Monday with Makkah. Because fasting is associated with our fellow Hujjaj. When it comes to Salah, Eid al-Adha itself is not related to the Hujjaj. So if you want to make it Tuesday, mashallah. If you want to make it Wednesday, mashallah. So Eid Mubarak to all of you, inshallah. Allah bless you. Here we will start Eid Salah like we always do. Our Eid program starts at 8 o'clock, inshallah. That will be Wednesday, by the way. And bless all of you. Allah, and forgive me. Thank you.